Trussell, along with Corey Macklin. And to my delight, we're delighted to have Sid Vicious back with us.
Well, thanks, Lance. It's good to be here.
I was down under the weather and missed it last week, Sid. I was sorry to hear about the fact that you're making the decision to pull out of active wrestling because of the injury. But sometimes that happens, but we're tickled to death you decided to come be with us.
Well, I'll tell you something. It was driving me crazy sitting at home. I was home no more than about a month, 6 weeks there, and it was eating my insides out. And like I said last week, Randy Hales gave me a phone call. I was down here last week, and I'm here this week, Lance. And I hope I'm here for a while.
Good. We got some reinforcement over here now. Dave is off this week, and of course, we'll be back next week. Son of a gun, I'll tell you, we have got a great show lined up. Tell you about it in a moment. We've got some good news and bad news, Corey.
Oh, boy. Bad news is that the losers of the Loser Leave Town this past week, PG-13, the losers. Richard Gilbert came out
stunned
on the top. Yeah, I called you after the matches there and told you about it. And, boy, it was a stunner indeed.
Mm. Hey, well, that wasn't all. It wasn't just bad news. We had some good news out of it, too, Sid.
The good news was the King, he marched right through that tournament, and he brought home the Unified World title. And I'll tell you something, Lance. I held that title for almost a year in here, and I'll tell you something. When you get something like that around your waist, you're going to fight and fight hard for it.
I'll tell you, too, Sid, that you're the best one to make a judge of this, the fact that, what is this?
What is this?
Hey, son, later on in the show, look, Mo, we don't want to get off on a bad foot, but later on in the show, we're expecting you out here. You got a match?
Lance Russell, shut up. Corey Macklin and Sid Vicious, let me tell you something. You better be glad you're in retirement, because I was never afraid of you in the first place. And if you had any guts, you jump in the ring with me right now, and I'll stump you. Hey, you get out of here. I've got something to say. One thing that you said that is correct. The King marched right through that tournament at the Mid-South Coliseum.
Beat Fable in the end of it.
No. See, you've got it mixed up. The King, the original King, the one and only King. That's King Mabel. Now, what I want you to do for me right now, Lance Russell, is I want you to pull out the tape of the show at the Mid-South Coliseum, and let's run the tape back and show how King Mabel beat Jerry Lawler 1-2-3 in the ring.
I don't think that happened, Mo.
Excuse me?
I don't think that happened. I think if we pulled out that tape, sir, and we showed it to these people, what we'd see was Jerry Lawler the King marching his butt right through there and get his hand raised at the end.
What I think you saw is wrong, incorrect. What I saw is King Mabel beat Jerry Lawler 1-2-3.
Now
let me tell you something, brother. Shut up, I'm talking, boy. Don't talk when I'm talking. All you people out here, shut up. Let me tell you something. Brother, it's the WWF, the USWA, shut up. Let me tell you something, Lance Russell. Brother, it's the WWF, the USWA, the Mid-South, the Southeast, East Coast, West Coast, Midwest. It doesn't matter. Everywhere that Men on a Mission go, we rule everything. And you suit and tie guys who run these promotions try to keep us down like you've always kept us down. But let me tell you something. The day has come when you will no longer keep Men on a Mission down, because we are going to take over the USWA. We are going to rule the wrestling world, and not you. Look at me when I'm talking to you, boy. And especially not you, you washed up piece of garbage. None of you are going to stop King Mabel and Sir Mo. I now proclaim. The USWA as the kingdom of King Mabel and Sir Mo.
You just let us have our kingdom back. Mo coming out here and starting off with that kind of garbage, and you're going to hear it, Sid, from now on.
Well, Lance, I tell you what, I got here early this morning, I heard the rumor that they said that they were going to do exactly what he just said, and he said they're going to wreak havoc in the USWA, and they started out this morning doing that.
He has definitely done that.
Well, I'll tell you one thing, they're not going to stop the fact we've got a great show coming up, and we have really got a dandy I think you're going to enjoy. We'll see Men on the Mission in action in here. Brian Christopher is going to be with us today. Also, they've been strutting around talking about how they beat PG-13. Tommy Rich and Doug Gilbert will be here. And our big main event, tell them what it is, Corey.
Well, it will be Tracy Smothers taking on Jesse James Armstrong right here today, Marie. It is a huge main event today.
Take time out. We'll be back with our opening bout with Men on a Mission in the ring in just one moment.
This is WCW, Uncensored. The immortal Hulk Hogan battles four men in four separate cages in wrestling's first ever Doomsday match. Sting and Lex Luger brawl with the Road Warriors in a Chicago street fight. Falls count anywhere as the Macho Man collides with Crippler Chris Benoit. Much more. Anything goes at WCW, Uncensored. Live at the Tupelo Coliseum, Sunday, March 24th, 4:30 p.m. Tickets available at all Memphis area Ticketmaster outlets.
We're back here on USWA Championship Wrestling, and a big tag team match coming up, Lance.
Well, this is one of those situations where you've got a favorite, definitely, Sid. The big Men on a Mission team, they've got to be a major. Well, we've only got Mo on.
Here it is again, Sid.
Hey, Ring, that's where you're
supposed to be. I know you're getting tired of seeing my face, Lance Russell,
right.
But I really don't care what you're getting tired of. Let me tell you something. As I said before, we're going to take over USWA, and we're not going to start next week. We're going to start right now. I present to you King Mabel.
We do know him. You're looking at almost 900 pounds of guys that are climbing in that ring. How about the introductions, Corey?
Indeed, coming in at a combined weight, as referee Downtown Bruno calls for the bell early. A combined weight, Men on a Mission at 889 pounds. Sermo and King Mabel taking on a team of Ripley Prim and the Shadow.
I'll tell you something, boy, those guys are putting it out this morning. I'll tell you something, I wouldn't want to be those other two boys across that ring for nothing right now.
Well, they're getting started, and what a tough way to get started, Lance. When you look at a team, you look across there, and your match today sign is Mabel and Mo.
Catches him with that flying sidekick. Yeah, it's bad enough to go against Men on a Mission.
Is that all you people got here?
They're coming in here, and they've had that mouth run by Mo like that, and now they're trying to back it up and show it's double bad news. One, two, and he picks him up, and he pins him.
I'm going to tell you something. Mabel's accidentally hurt more people wrestling in this world than anybody combined.
Believe it when you look at the size of him. Mo putting Ripley Prim right back down in the middle of that ring, pounding him, and they have got such a weight advantage, but also the experience and the caliber of wrestling that they've been going against.
No doubt about it. The Shadow steps in, and Mo tags his partner and stepping into the ring, or over the ring, I guess I must say. King Mabel. Pounds down all of that 565 pounds. Boy, what a big guy. Just drops the Shadow like a sack of potatoes.
I'm looking at it from the Shadow standpoint. Count of one, two, three. Yeah. Got him, and that's going to be it.
That is all she wrote. Mabel and Mo, Men on a Mission, get the win. And it was, you see that? The bout is over with. See that kind of stuff, man?
Ring the bell.
That's ridiculous. Come on, shove Bruno out of the ring.
They hear the bell. They're doing exactly what they said earlier, and they're going to start it right now. I'll tell you something. There's no sense of saying anything trying to stop it, because they're not going to stop.
Yeah, I think you got it right. They figure that they are on a mission, and their mission is to prove they're the baddest suckers around as Mo shoves the referee back.
Come on.
All right. Hey.
Where's Ring the Hell?
Ripley Prim in the Shadow, feeling the brunt of this mission that they have to prove that they're the baddest dude around. And look at that Shadow getting banged by Mabel.
Man, I'll tell you something, Lance. I don't disagree with this. When I was wrestling in the ring, I'm going to do what I have to do to get my point across. But there's a point that maybe too much is too much.
And this is an example entirely of too much. Come on, you guys, for crying out loud.
Well, he snaps the shadow right off of the rope after choking him. Referee Bruno has went out and gotten some help. And here they are. Here's Tony Myers, Adrian Hines in there to try to help these other guys out.
I tell you what, if I was Bruno, I'd stay out of there.
Yeah, he jumped back in. Come on, God! Paul drives him. And men on a mission just gone berserk,
Lance.
You could come along and disqualify him right now and take the win away, and it wouldn't mean a thing. They would just keep right on doing what they're trying to do.
They don't care. They don't care, and this proves it.
Look at this. Holy Ripley Prim, and that big Mabel just slapping away at him. Here comes some help now. Here comes Jesse James Armstrong, too sexy for his sister. Boy, Armstrong with that chair.
Look out.
Christopher goes after Mo and Mabel, and Armstrong and Christopher come out, and finally we're able to get men on a mission out of the ring, but they're not out of the studio as of yet. Oh, they're still hanging around looking for trouble. Oh, yeah. They're not running from anything. There's Mabel just lingering around here to see what else he can get into. These guys, I tell you.
I tell you something, Jesse's taking a big chance coming out. He's got a main event today.
Yes, he does. Big Gracie Smothers, we're looking forward to it. Take time out right now and be back in a moment. Too Sexy Brian Christopher scheduled up in the ring next, guys, and we'll be looking forward to that. Additionally, Tommy Rich, Doug Gilbert will be out here a little bit later on. And our big main event, as Sid mentioned a moment ago, Jesse James Armstrong will be taking on Tracy Smothers. A lot of bad blood between them. Uh-oh.
Look at this guy. Where do you get that coat at, Corey?
Oh, boy, I don't know. Reggie B. Fine. At least he's wearing it around the right time of the year. This guy, he'll sport that coat in mid-July. I think he really believes in that zero in July, boy. This guy.
I think that has a little bit new to his repertoire right there.
Strutting around. A lot of class with that hat on in there. He better have a lot of class today because he's going against Too Sexy Brian Christopher. You know one thing I've always said, Sid, about Reggie. Reggie comes out and he acts a fool and he does a lot of crazy stuff in there. The guy's got all the physical tools. He's big. And he can wrestle.
Well, I'll tell you something. This right here might just be a little bit of a front, maybe to fool this guy, but I'll tell you something. I don't think Brian's going to fall for it.
Reggie be fine. He's taking off his $7,000 fur coat, he says, man.
He said $10,000
for the earring. Oh, he just went up $10,000 for the earring.
There
it is. Too Sexy. Brian Christopher making his way around the ring. And he is the proud holder of that good-looking USWA heavyweight title. Stepping into the ring now. 266 pounds. Says it from every woman's dream, Reggie B. Fine. And his opponent today, making his way around the ring area, the USWA heavyweight champion out of Memphis, Tennessee, Too Sexy Brian Christopher. And Reggie B. Fine jumps in right before the bell, sir.
Just like I said, that old coat and that hat was a smokescreen. He took advantage of Brian turning around. And he's going to try to make it work for him today.
Brian Christopher, the USWA heavyweight champion. The belt is off. That brand new, beautiful belt, you might add,
from
a week old. And Reggie, you think this is the only way he's going to be able to get Christopher with a surprise at the beginning? What's he got to do to beat him?
I don't think he needed to do that, but he thinks he needs to do that. And when you do something like that, I don't know if it's God or just let him fall against you or something like that.
Sid, you've been in the ring for a long time in professional wrestling. When, in a case like this, when a guy jumps in, doesn't it make you a little bit angrier?
Well, of course, if you ever get that chance to come up on top, your adrenaline's going to be up, pumped up a little more, and you're going to be able to step it up when you have to.
Reggie B. Fine just made himself a big mistake.
jumping Christopher from the start of that bell. Of course, Brian's down now.
I'll tell you something. If I was done with Reggie and jumped him from the beginning, I would have never let up. I stay on him hard, fast, out of finishing. He's taking a little bit too much time in between these
things. Well, going for a pin here.
Two! We got a two count right there and almost dead. The USWA heavyweight champ on a pin in a non-title match. And he's staying right on him, Sid, just like you said. He can't resist hot dogging, though, and that may be one of his problems.
Whoa! What'd I tell you?
Finally, the jacket comes off from Too Sexy. Brian Christopher and Christopher pounds down on Reggie B. Fine. Again, he nails him.
Now Brian's getting his revenge.
Boy, Christopher unloads on him.
Distracting, Sid. When Brian Christopher gets up in a guy's face and starts that inane laugh, that's got to be distracting.
That's driving me crazy sitting over here.
Look at that.
Nailed Reggie with that big right hand from outside the ring.
Too sexy.
He looks like setting up that super kick.
What's it done? Reggie turned around. Drop kick from Christopher.
Super kick. He called it. He called it.
Sid over here. Sid calling for it.
The people are calling for it.
Christopher backs him up. Oh. Reversal here. Reggie B with him in. Brian slides under. Comes for it. Super kick from Christopher. Oh, he's climbing the ladder now, up on the top rope. Too sexy. Coming down. Drops a leg on Mr. Reggie B. Fine. Two. Good night, Howie. That's going to do it.
I asked me the other day, I said, how did he come off that top rope like that? I said, brother, I don't know. I wouldn't do that for nothing.
He really was flying all the way to the middle of the ring. And Reggie B. bemoaning the fact that he had him going, but it doesn't mean a thing until the 1-2-3 comes. So we are going to take time out. More action in just a moment. Sorry about that, Reggie. Major main event when we've got Tracy Smothers, Jesse James Armstrong will be facing each other. Want to remind everybody that this coming week there will be no action in the Mid-South Coliseum, or at least there will be no wrestling action. Unfortunately, from that standpoint, the Coliseum is engaged. And so the return to Memphis will be on the 18th of the month. That'll be on Monday, the March the 18th. Action will be back, and we'll have more on it as we get along. Son of a gun, we had enough action last week with that tournament. You know, you were talking about holding the title and fighting. When you go through a tournament like that, and when you've got the kind of, well, here he comes, the king. This is the guy right here. He won it. Ended up beating Mabel for the Unified World Heavyweight title. The king, Jerry Lawler, walking with that belt. And is he feeling good with that belt back around his waist?
Well, I'll tell you, Lance, you know, you mentioned the tournament. There was a lot of talk out here last week. You weren't here. I wish you had been here last week because...
I do, too. I was down with a flu.
I'll tell you, you missed it. We had a lot of people shooting their mouths off about what all they were going to do in this tournament, especially Brian Christopher. I mean, you know, he was out here telling everybody about that he was certainly, assuredly, without a doubt, unquestionably, positively going to beat him.
Yes, first round.
Well, all I can say is, Brian... Take a look at this, pal. Now, there were some other guys in this tournament other than Brian Christopher. It boiled down to me and another king, King Mabel. Now, I want to tell you something. We just saw this guy, and I'm going to tell Brian Christopher, and I'm going to tell all of the rest of the guys here that this is somebody that we cannot let get a foothold here in the USWA, because between he and Sir Mo, I mean, you know, they could take over around here. So, Brian, you and I and all of the rest of these guys, Armstrong, whoever we got left without PG-13,
we're going to have to band together because something's going to have to be done about King Mabel and Sir Mo and get those two jerks out of here once and for all. But all I want to say is it was great to win this. Like you said, Lance, it is a great feeling to have this back around my waist. I feel
wait
like this.
Wait just a minute, King, I have something to
Brandon do. Baxter.
Take a look at this. Excuse me, King, will you look and listen to me when I'm talking, huh? This man is Yoshi Kwan. This man is a man who has been all over the world and has defeated everybody he's ever stepped in the ring with. You like to call yourself a world heavyweight champion, right? You like to pride yourself on being a heavyweight champion, but Jerry Lawler, where have you been? This man has gone to Germany, he's gone to Hong Kong, he's gone to Japan. You have stayed in Memphis, and you call yourself a world heavyweight champion, and you're in Memphis. Well, let me give you credit. You're right. You're right, Jerry Lawler. Go ahead and keep your mouth closed. You've wrestled all over the United States, and you have beat all kinds of top superstars. But you have never had to face a man as demented, as sick, and as twisted as Yoshi Kwan. And right now, this is a challenge. He is here for one reason. He is here for that gold to put it around mine and his waist.
Well, it never ends. They just keep on coming at you.
What? No, I'm not scared. I'm just, I'm maybe a little bit confused. You know, I just won this title last week, and now all of a sudden, I knew it would happen, Lance. It always happens. This belt has a habit of bringing all the insects out of the woodwork, so to speak. And that's exactly what I feel about you, Brandon Baxter. When I look at you, that's exactly what I see. I see some sort of little worm, some sort of little insect who dreams at night. He goes to sleep dreaming at night, wishing that he had the guts, wishing that he had the size, wishing that he had the body to be able to step in the ring and compete against somebody else. But unfortunately, Brandon Baxter, you weren't blessed with all of those things, were you? So what you do, like a leech, that's what you are, like a leech, you attach yourself to somebody that can do your dirty work for you. And now I guess this is your latest, you parasite, this is your latest victim here. Yoshi Kwan, is that the name, Yoshi Kwan, huh? I don't know Yoshi Kwan from Joe Blow. You may say that he's been all around the world beating everybody he stepped in the ring with. Well, you're right. I stay here in Memphis a lot. But let me tell you something. I do a lot of traveling with the World Wrestling Federation, and I can tell you this. I've never heard of Yoshi Kwan. You can probably write the names of everybody he's beaten on the head of a pin and still have room for the yellow pages. What you're doing is coming out here, running your mouth, trying to make a name for himself. So what he's going to have to do, he's going to have to prove himself to me. But most importantly, he's going to have to prove himself to the USWA officials and to all of these fans out here before he earns a shot at the World Heavyweight Championship. You got to earn this, pal. You got to get your title shots the old-fashioned way. You got to earn them.
You obviously must be a little bit scared and a little bit afraid of this man, and as well you should be. But by saying this man doesn't get a title shot right now, you're putting a nail in your own coffin. It's just like signing your own death warrant. And Jerry Lawler, you do me one favor. You watch, because in just a little while, I'm going to bring this man back out here, and you watch what he does. He will not only beat someone, he will put them out, and that is exactly what he'll do to you, and we will take that belt home with us.
Until the time comes that you've earned the shot at it, Brandon, just go back and dream on. Now, before we were so rudely interrupted, we've gotten the congratulations for winning it, and it was a great win in that tournament. And Jerry, what's in the future?
Well, I just want to say, you know, as I said, I'm sure that this title is going to bring a lot of people out of the woodwork. There are a lot of people that would love to have a title shot at this. I think number one on the list would be Brian Christopher. I'm sure King Mabel thinks he deserves another shot at this, but that's what it's all about. And I think everybody that knows that when I won the AWA championship, and then I won the World Class Championship, and we unified the titles, they know from that point on I was a fighting champion. So anybody that wants a shot at this belt, I'm not going to be hiding in any closets. I'm not going to be hard to find. I'm going to be right here every Saturday morning on TV5. Come looking for me, pal, because you want a shot at this belt, you can have it anytime, any place, right here.
Here's a guy that never backed up from anybody, and we'll be seeing him around for a while. Take time out. Come back. We've got more action in the ring in just a moment. One of the more shocking things that took place is the loser leave town match that ended up between Rich and Gilbert and PG-13, and PG-13 lost it.
What a shocker. Here are two guys that started out here in the USWA, Lance, I guess around the time that I began here with my announcing and joining Dave, and of course, you working with us also, and they I guess in a matter of 3 or 4 years they became fan favorites, Sid, and you know, it was a bout that a lot of intensity, and I mean it was going back and forth, and the intensity level there during that match, I would have bet my life savings that PG-13 was going to come out victorious, but all of a sudden, just out of nowhere, Tommy Rich comes up with a fire extinguisher. I mean, it was just all of a sudden, and he just blows it. I mean,
no man, place in the ring at all.
Not only a match, you know, it could have cost him the match, which it did, but I mean, this is a life-threatening deal here also with Rich pulling that fire extinguisher out and just spraying it all over Woofy, and they got the 1-2-3. Awful situation.
I'm going to tell you something. I don't hold anything against anybody. You got to do what you got to do to win something, win a match. But when you go to that extreme, to maybe put out a guy's eyes,
look too far,
mess up his whole life, the rest of his life, that's a little bit too far.
Oh, yeah.
A little bit too far.
You know, they have been some of the most exciting wrestlers that we've ever seen around, and I think they certainly deserve an opportunity for some final words to the USWA. So here they are, PG-13.
First of all, we'd like to start off by telling the USWA we appreciate him giving us one last chance to say our words before we go. What I would like to start off by saying was I'd like to thank each and every person watching this show, whether you loved us or you hated us. I'd like to thank you for your support and let you know that it wasn't for you that PG-13 would have never made it where we made it today. Now we face the toughest challenge of our life, which is having to go somewhere else and try to start over, basically make another name for ourselves where we can feed our families and ourselves. But there comes a time in a man's life when he's got to do what he's got to do. And Tommy Rich and Doug Gilbert did what they had to do to stay in the USWA. So J.C. Ice and Wolfie D have to pack up and move on. But I just want to thank each and every one of you people from the bottom of my heart and let you know that J.C. Ice will always remember the fans of the USWA, and I hope you never forget us, and I thank you for all your support. Wolfie?
Yeah, well, you basically covered everything there. I just want to thank everybody again for supporting PG-13 from when we were two little guys that nobody took seriously, and we got beat every night till where we worked hard and became champions numerous times. And I want to thank everybody that stuck with us through all of that. This is something I've grown up in Nashville my whole life, and now, like you said, we got to pick up and we got to move on. But I guess sometimes in your life you come to a fork in the road and you got to decide which way you're going to go. Maybe PG-13 is going to remain a team and we'll go somewhere else. Maybe we'll go our separate ways. Maybe we won't never wrestle again. I don't know. And he probably don't know right now. This is a big decision. But I just want to say thank you to everybody, and we appreciate everything everybody's done for us.
Thank you, USWA.
J.C. Ice, Wolfie D, PG-13, and our final comment from the tag team of PG-13. Well, here is Scott Bowden.
That had to be the saddest thing I've ever seen in my life. Where was that interview taking place? I think that was the Greyhound bus station downtown, wasn't it? Hey, they don't know what to do now. Hey, I heard McDonald's is hiring, but I think they're underqualified. You know, the name of the game was Losers Leave Town. And for once, one of Randy Hales' matches actually lived up to the billing, because the two biggest losers I've ever met in my life are gone. They're history. Sayonara. So long, suckers. And I know some of you idiots over here from the hood may not understand matches that have stipulations. So what I did, I brought out my own hood dictionary here. I got a glossary of terms. What it's all about, yo, yo, yo. My two homeboys, Tommy Rich and Doug Gilbert,
I put the stone cold diss on those two turkeys, PG-13. And if you don't like the way we did it, talk to the hand, because the ears don't understand. You know what I'm saying? Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, baby. Tommy Richard, Doug Gilbert, Scott Bowden, the championship dynasty is here. We're going through them all. I told everyone when I started Operation White Trash that we were going to clean up all the garbage. We got two down. Brian Christopher, Jerry Lawler, look over your shoulders, baby. Operation White Trash is in full swing.
Yeah, they're loving it. Scott Bowden, Tommy Rich, and Doug Gilbert. Real funny, Rich.
Oh, Tommy, let me get that for you, baby.
How were they at? I wish that we beat all the WWF boys. Look at something, you take it to the bank. Where is Jamie Dundee?
Well, they took it like a man. They took it like men, and they lost the match, and they're gone.
They are gone for good. So all you need to do is we got the gold now, brother. Step in line, boys, and bring it down. Because Dangerous Doug and myself, we ain't never run from nobody. And we sure as hell ain't starting now.
Now, see, Corey Macklin, what Tommy Rich is actually trying to say. We've had a lot of real important matches with PG-13s. We've had hair matches. What happened? They got their heads shaved. We had cage matches. What happened? They got beat. We had a loser leave town match, and what happened? We're standing here, and they're gone. Now, Corey Macklin, let me give the devil their due. All I've heard you stand out here and say, all I've heard old dinosaur Lance Russell stand out here and say, is PG-13 is the toughest tag team for the last 3 years. They've held these tag team belts you're looking at around my waist and over Tommy Rich's shoulder for about the entire past 3 years. Well, see, PG-13, for the last 3 years, it's been nothing but PG-13 in tag teams. Tommy Rich has been a singles champion all his life. I am a five-time USWA heavyweight champion. Don't forget that. So what I'm saying is, boys, for the last 3 years, you were the men. No, hold it. They won't be back because they lost the loser leave town match. But what I am saying, Tommy, why we're the champions, Randy Hales, I think what you need to be, see what it's like when you're at the A class, you're at the top. When you're on the A crew, you're on the top. When you're in the B crew, you're just a little bit below. Well, see, PG-13, you're not even on a crew. See, the B crew was PG-13, but I'm going to be honest with you, Corey Macklin. Now, I don't know if Tommy is sad or not, but I'll be honest. I'm glad PG-13's gone because I'm glad we don't ever have to deal with them again because what? Why don't you quit mumbling while I'm talking? But what I do want to ask Corey Macklin, if I can get between your mumbles, is if Randy Hales, which I know is around here somewhere, if I could get him out here, what I'm wondering now, since me and Tommy are so much above everybody, if he could get us any kind of competition.
Come on out here, boys. He's probably back there crying because Wolfie D's gone and can't ride with him.
Oh, come on, Rich.
Let's get him the opportunity to answer my question.
You have a match in the ring now, Doug. Let's go up to the ring.
Okay.
Yeah, that's right.
No.
Hold it, guys. Hold it. This is serious.
Randy, I understand where you're coming from because, see, Tommy, I walked in a little bit in front of you this morning. And, Randy Hales, I don't even really know how you found your way to Memphis to the studio in that Cadillac without Whoopi D driving you. See what happened? Look, Tommy, I walked in the door this morning, and Randy Hales was down like this with his tail going, my little boy lost. My little boy lost. But see, Randy Hales.
Hey, you shut up. I'm sick of this. Everybody knows exactly how you won the match. It's the most disgusting thing I've ever seen. But I'll tell you this. All week long, I've had about 30 teams call me wanting to come to the USWA. About 30 different people. You want competition, you'll get competition. I promise you. And you won't be laughing next week. I promise you.
Well, that's the word from promoter Randy Hales.
He's threatening us.
We got a match coming up. Yeah, let's get to it. Finally, maybe we can get these guys in there. Scott Bowden, Tommy Rich, and Doug Gilbert. Come on. USWA Tag Team Champions, and of course, this is a non-title match. T.D. Steele starting off for his team of T.D. Steele in the yellow jacket, taking on Tommy Wildfire Rich, Dangerous Doug Gilbert, the USWA Tag Team Champions, with Scott Bowden in their corner.
I'll tell you this, guys, Men on a Mission started out today, started a bunch of ruckus out here. I thought it couldn't get any worse than that. I think it just did.
Yeah, I think you're right about that, Sid. Wildfire Tommy Rich takes T.D. Steele and deposits him on the floor. Yellow Jacket, the partner of T.D. Steele. And while we've got it going, referee Chip Namius in his first, telling you, he popped him right over and down on the studio floor, Sid.
Not again. Oh, wow. Did you hear that, Lance? Man, I can't believe he's getting up. Oh,
come on, Doug. Do it in the ring.
Not three times. Corey, get up and stop this.
Oh, man, I tell you.
Get up there, Corey. Stop this. About this.
I guess this is what Randy Hales meant by all this tough competition. Oh my, we are so overwhelmed, let me tell you.
Wildfire Tommy Rich, belly to belly, and he takes him over and down. TD down in the middle of the ring. Yellow Jacket comes in, puts a foot on Rich to break it up with the bowl.
Seems like Scott Bowden never stops. It's on and on and on and on with him. What do you
think? You've noticed, huh? Boy, I mean to tell you, he can get on your nerves so bad. Hey, just stay in there and wrestle with you guys.
He's always got to direct it to us. We're not the ones that line up the competition for him, because I'll tell you something, if I was in charge of that, I'd have some competition up there for him.
Well, here's a tag man on the Yellow Jacket. Yellow Jacket is the competition today for Rich and Gilbert, along with T.D. Steele, his partner, and they are taking advantage of this team of Yellow Jacket and T.D. Steele. Look at that.
I don't know if T.D.'s going to be able to be much help the rest of this match after taking three of those suplexes out here on the floor.
Boy, I mean, right smack on the studio floor, too. Tag goes. Gilbert to Wildfire Tommy Rich. We'll watch it, Doug. That's why we came, as a matter of fact. On the shoulder of Gilbert, and he backbreaker right down onto the floor. One, two, three.
Don't get up from that. You won't get up from that.
That'll do it. Rich and Gilbert, victorious.
I think they just killed that guy. What's his name? The Bumblebee? Call 911, Lance. He's dead.
We'll take time out. We'll be back in just one moment. Yeah, next week we'll be out.
Yeah, Lance and I are just talking about.
while the camera and mics are on, guys, why don't we go ahead and do what we're supposed to do, Corey?
We're talking about Memphis coming up Monday night, March 18th. No wrestling at the Coliseum this coming week, but we will return Monday night, March 18th, Mid-South Coliseum down there. Big night of action is signed for Monday night, March 18th, when the USWA returns to the Mid-South Coliseum. Hey, coming up Friday night, Friday, March 15th, Paragould, Arkansas. There at the B.C. Lord Building at the fairgrounds. 7:30 is bell time, and you see the top two names, Jerry Lawler, Bill Dundee. Well, these guys just will not quit, Lance. There will be a non-sanctioned match with Jerry Lawler versus Bill Dundee right there in Paragould, Arkansas, Friday night, the 15th, along on that card, also Sir Mo, Tommy Rich, Duck Gilbert, Miz Texas, an all-star card signed for Paragould. You do not want to miss it there at the B.C. Lord Building at the fairgrounds. Wednesday, March 20th, we'll be back at the Sheraton Casino Center. Boy, it is great for wrestling action there. King Mabel and Sir Mo will be there. Dr. Isaac Yankum signed for that card as well. The King, Jerry Lawler, Too Sexy Brian Christopher, all at
out to Sheraton Casino at Casino Center. That's coming up Wednesday the 20th.
That is a lot of fun down there, I gotta tell you.
Isn't it?
Yeah, that's some great cards, too, I guarantee.
Oh, indeed. Friday, March 22nd, Blytheville, Arkansas, Nation of God. I'm Rick D. Vision Street. 8 p.m. is the start time. Two Sexy Brian Christopher, Sir Mo, a World Championship Battle Royal, and the King, Jerry Lawler, will defend that unified title in Blytheville, Arkansas, Saturday, March 23rd, back in Jonesboro, Arkansas, Earl Bell Community Center on Church Street in Jonesboro. That is USWA Championship Wrestling on Tour, and we've got more coming up here.
You better believe we got a main event we're looking forward to. All of us are looking forward to seeing Tracy Smothers, Jesse James, Armstrong. That's going to be a good one, and we'll be getting to that in a moment. Right now, take time out. We'll be back. Well, I tell you guys, my curiosity is up over this Yoshi Kwan that'll be in here. I've never seen...
There he is.
There he is.
Hang on just a minute, old man. What I want to do right now is formally introduce this man to the entire viewing world. He is a master of every form of martial arts imaginable. He knows every single submission hold, and he can kill a man with his bare hands. I'm talking about Yoshi Kwan. And the reason he's here is to do everything and get rid of everybody that has problems with B&B Enterprises. That includes Jerry Lawler, Brian Christopher, and anybody else who wants to step in my way. This man is going to wreak so much havoc. He's so strange, and he's so demented that Eddie Marlin and Randy Hales are going to come to me and say, Brandon Baxter, I am begging you, please get this man out of the USWA. What I want you people to do is sit there, pull your chairs up close to the TV, and pay real close attention, because this is the future of the USWA. Right now, he is going to go to the ring and destroy Tony Williams. Tony Williams is going to wish he was resting in peace right now in a coffin. Take care.
Well, we are interested in seeing him. That's for a fact. We've heard a lot about him, as a matter of fact, that he does have a lot of things going for him. Bell time, and here we go, downtown Bruno.
I was just asking Brandon Baxter, I said, if you know somebody about what is his finishing hold? He said, the Sleeping Dragon. I don't know if I've ever seen that
Sleeping
one before.
Dragon.
Tony Williams out of Cordova going in and about 200 pounds facing off against this Yoshi Kwan. Kwan comes in at 220 pounds. Wrestling out of Hong Kong. Look at this. Boy, right onto the concrete floor. Kwan drops down on Tony Williams.
That had to be 10 or 15 feet in the air, Corey.
Boy.
100% disaster, you see that?
He's over here running around again.
Brandon Baxter, doing he does best, running his mouth. Kwan's gonna get himself counted out here on the floor if he doesn't get back in there. Slams Tony Williams right on our desk over here. Well, that's not a very great wrestling hold, Brandon Baxter. He's choking him with a cable. Or crying out loud. That doesn't show any talent. Just that he is demented, I would say that. Is that one of his great wrestling holds?
This man can beat a man with his bare hands. This man can go out there and he can beat a man at any given time, in any given match. He is the future of the USWA. He will lead Brandon Baxter straight to the top.
I think Brandon's been watching two Bruce Lee movies.
I think so. Yoshi Kwan from Hong Kong drops down with a leg drop. I understand that. From behind, the referee counts on him as he was gouging at the eyes and the mouth of Tony Williams. Tony really never got off the ground in this match in there, and all it's doing is going downhill.
It's been Yoshi Kwan the whole time.
Look at that kick from Yoshi Kwan. Picks him up right at the one count. And I must say that our first look today at Yoshi Kwan on USWA Wrestling has been quite impressive.
Kwan takes one to the midsection, doesn't hardly slow him down. Right back after Tony Williams with the hand. Ooh, he went for that pressure point right under the armpit.
That's it.
Sleeping Dragon.
Ring the bell.
And Tony Williams submits to it. And boy, he won't let go.
Brandon, break it up. He's won the match. Come on. Break it up.
Come on, referee. Stop this. Stop. Hey, don't pay no attention to him. Stop the Washi Kwan over there. What he's doing right now, guys, he's holding that artery over there. He's stopping the blood from getting to the brain. And I'll tell you something, you can cause some serious damage with that.
Yoshi Kwan comes out the victor over Tony Williams. Tonight he wouldn't break it up when the referee told him to break it. Now he goes back and gets Williams, throws him right through the ropes and out on the floor. The winner, Yoshi Kwan.
Will you shut up? He went through a Chinese noodle
swamp. Boy, I guess. Well, we've got a new face around. It's not the prettiest face I ever saw, but it was the face of a victor.
What did he say?
Take his hat with him.
What'd you say, Brandon?
Got it. Yeah. Come on, take him out of here.
Still got a big main event coming up here, guys.
We still have plenty of big wrestling. And speaking about big wrestling, I was tickled to death in Corey, and I hope, Sid, that you had the opportunity to get one of these. Randy Hales presented us with a copy of A Night to Remember. This is the 25th anniversary of the Louisville wrestling in the Louisville Gardens up there.
I didn't have a chance to be there that night, but you're right. Randy Hales did give me one last week after the show. I went home and watched it. I'll tell you something. That's some of the best wrestling I've ever seen in my life.
It was a heck of a night, wasn't it, Corey?
It was great. Great atmosphere right there in the gardens, as always down there at the Louisville Gardens.
And this, these are signed and numbered copies of them. Just a limited number are going to be put out. But I know that you'll be interested in hearing more about it because it was before a spectacular crowd in the Louisville Gardens. And there's a couple of ways that you can get a hold of it. You can use your MasterCard or Visa when you make the call. 1-800-246-0356. Or you can send $24.95 plus $4.95 for shipping and handling to Global Distributors, 3120A Ridge Pike, Eagleville, Pennsylvania, 19403. Allow 4 to 6 weeks for delivery. And that's A Night to Remember. And I'll guarantee you, if you're a wrestling fan, this is one that you'd like to have right there in the old collection of cassettes, because
no
it is a beauty right there. Night to Remember. We hope maybe you'll take the opportunity to add that to your collection. We'll take time out and be back in just one moment.
I said earlier he's going to have to impress not just me, but he's going to have to impress everybody. Let me ask, were you people impressed by the Yoshi Kwan, huh?
What can I say?
What can I say? I will say this, look. That lamp will never be the same, will it? Yoshi Kwan, you forgot your lampshade. Come on, man. Anyway, I just wanted to come out here for a second and mention, you know, I heard Corey mention all the places we're going to be over in Paragould, Arkansas, and in Blytheville, Arkansas, coming up. And a fantastic card, as he mentioned, going to be down at the Sheraton Casino. I'm really looking forward to that. And as you said, Lance, it's a lot of fun. Last time you and I went down, we had the big buffet.
Yeah.
And the whole works.
Yeah.
And I've never seen anybody eat as much boiled shrimp as Lance Russell.
Oh, come on.
Well, except for Corey. Corey now really puts the boiled shrimp away. But anyway, we're looking forward to being back down there. It's going to be big. I also wanted to mention a couple other things just real quick. I only take a second. Next Saturday afternoon, a lot of people know, you know, every now and then I make appearances at different places, and they're always asking, hey, King, got any free tickets? Well, next Saturday afternoon, get ready for this. They're going to have a big weekend out at Bluff City Autoplex. My good friend Bobby Ward at Bluff City Used Cars going to be out there next weekend from 1 until 3, and I'm going to have over 100 tickets, not only to TV, but to Monday Night Wrestling. And you know what, Lance? A lot of people ask you know, at home I have this big, nice, royal throne that I sit in, you know, when I'm sitting around watching TV, watching you on TV and that sort of stuff. Well, the people at Bluff City Autoplex are going to come over. They're going to bring my throne out there. I'm going to be dressed out in the whole regalia. So bring your cameras. I'm going to let the fans, if they want to, they can actually sit in the throne that I have at home and have their pictures made, all this kind of stuff. It's going to be next week, 1 to 3, Bluff City Autoplex. Now, real quick, one other thing, and this will only take a second. You know, Lance, the time of year, it doesn't really feel like it out there today because I think it's about 1 degree or whatever. But
spring is going to be on us pretty soon, and we all know what happens.
Keep telling me that, Jerry. I need reinforcement right now.
I think that's why Dave is not here today. He's ashamed to show his face. But anyway, I promise you, it will be here eventually, and we all know what that means. I think the second most popular sport in Memphis, Tennessee, other than wrestling, has got to be slow-pitch softball. Mm-hmm. And everybody in Memphis gets involved, and of course, Lawler's Army gets cranked up. And a lot of the people, we were just over in Arkansas last night, and people were asking us about how do we schedule Lawler's Army to come to our town and help us raise some money for our organization. And if you've got a charity or an organization or a school or whatever that you want us to help raise some money for, all you got to do is schedule Lawler's Army. And I think there it is right there. And you call Mr. Guy Coffee, area code 901-358-2924. He's got all our open dates, and we'll be more than glad to come. Now, only one stipulation. You got to have a pretty decent softball team, because believe me, this year I got some guys, Lance. This is going to be our all-time best team ever. We're looking for an undefeated season. I got guys like Chris Ellsworth, Robert Reed, Robert Burgess, David Holcomb, Dal Val. All these guys are chomping at the bit. Ricky Grisham chomping at the bit, waiting to get a hold of some of these teams. So give us a call, line us up, and we'll be glad to come to your town, help you raise some money, but beat you in the process.
Okay. I had heard you'd been out talking with Michael Bolden about recruiting some of those monsters he's bringing there.
Michael Bolden, I'll tell you what, I'm gonna recruit Sid. And
there
Sid.
You go.
That'll finish off Michael Bolden or anybody else. We'll be ready for him. So just call Mr. Coffee, okay?
That's a great time when you get a hold of the Army and bring them to your town.
And don't forget us next week, Bluff City Autoplex 1-3.
Okay.
All right.
All right, bud.
We'll take you up on that invite.
The King! Well, oh, you're going to... Yeah! Can we get a
Don't look like you, King.
Well, following the King, here comes the USWA Heavyweight Champion, Brian Christopher.
My gosh! Is it time to wake up now that he's through out here running his mouth? How long was he out here?
I didn't have a stopwatch.
I fell asleep back there. I can't believe it. And did he mention my name on that softball team?
No.
Well, good, because I don't know if I'm going to play softball with Jerry Lawler. I don't know if I'm going to do anything with Jerry Lawler anymore after I heard him stand out here earlier today and do my laugh, Lance. Why didn't y'all let him stand out here and do my laugh?
Don't take it serious.
I'm taking it real serious because he is coming out here acting like he beat me. And I told you last week that he can't beat me, and he did not beat me. It went to a time limit draw. I had Jerry Lawler flat on his back when the time limit ran out and just giving him a big super kick. And then they tell me, time limit draw, we got to flip a coin to decide the winner. Is that any way to decide a winner?
Well, it's not the best way, but it's the only way in a draw.
It ain't the best way. It's no kind of way, because you know Jerry Lawler's the luckiest man on the planet. And so he did win the flip of the coin, and he thinks that he beat me? You didn't beat me, Lawler. I'm still the USWA Heavyweight Champion. And before it's over, I want a shot at your belt, that Unified Heavyweight Championship. So you just keep old Too Sexy in the back of your mind. And I got people in my mind, front and back, and one of them is Big King Mabel. 600 pounds. How much does he weigh?
He weighs just under six.
Just under 600 pounds. Well, King Mabel, you're on my mind, like I said. And I know that you're big. You can ask suspicious. You can ask a...
There he is, right there. Okay, guys. Let's try to keep it nice on a level.
This is my interview time.
Did you think I was just going to stay back in the back and listen to you talk trash about me? Any man who's not taller than the announcer doesn't stand a chance against King Mabel. You understand that? You midget. You're not a champion. I'm a champion. You don't understand that?
No, I'm the champion, and this is my interview time. You need to take your fat butt right out of here. You understand me? I'm not scared of nobody, not you, anybody.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
I think you're scared, punk.
Come on, Mabel.
No, he's out here. He's a champion. I think you're scared, boy. Huh? What's the problem?
Get out of there, man. I'm telling you, I'll be one on one. So I'm not scared.
You ain't scared?
No.
I think you are scared, boy.
Big Mabel out here trying to pick a fight right now with Brian Christopher.
I'm not scared. You want me one-on-one? You've got me one-on-one. You want to do it now? Let's do it now.
Come on, Mabel. Mabel grabs a hold of Christopher right by the throat, heaves him into the ring, and Big King Mabel moving up in there, all of that weight in there, bam, and down goes Brian. Christopher, what have we got our hands into now?
Lance, I'm a kid. They said it once, they said it twice, they said it three times, and they are following up on it. They are causing more trouble than we care to see.
Here comes the referee downtown, Bruno. We got ourselves an unscheduled bout. And I must say, a good unscheduled bout. Christopher and Mabel. Clothesline from Big Mabel. Well,
we got Mabel out here. The thing is, we know Mola's close by.
Yeah, you're right. Good point. Always watching the back, I presume, is Brian Christopher. Let that temper of his get himself into the middle of a situation in which he really didn't have to be, boy. He didn't have to stand out here and push it. But Christopher cannot stand for anybody to shove it at him.
Well, nobody can stand at
him. Well, I know it.
Like that, especially just to back up.
Look at those drop kicks, and man, they're not moving that Big Mabel. Standing there, and Christopher comes off the ropes. Drops him down to one knee, but the big guy yet to hit the mat. Christopher climbs the top, drops down on Mabel, and here's Mo.
Just what you said, Sid. There he is.
Come on, Mo, get out of here. Watch it, boy.
Come on, Mo. Stay out of it, would you? Come on. So now we got men on a mission, both in there, Mabel and Mo. Sexy Brian Christopher. Oh, my goodness.
I see Brian's in danger right now, guys. Get back.
Come. Let's get some help out of here.
Come on.
You get out of here.
Oh, no, not poor Bruno.
Bruno out of it. We're going to have to take a break here and try to get somebody in and get this one slowed down and see if we can get it here. Yeah.
Here comes
Chick Namius. We'll take time out. Be back in just a moment. Still trying to get Mabel and Mo out of the studio here. We've got a big main event coming up. Sid?
I'll tell you something, man. They're making a point all through the commercial break. They beat up on Brian Christopher.
You shut up, Sid Vicious. I'm the next USWA champion. And I heard exactly what you said. You said... And I hurt people accidentally.
I said you have hurt more people accidentally than most people has purposely. Yeah, I did say that.
Let me tell you something, boy. If your neck wasn't broke, I'd break it right now. You respect the king, and you respect the next USWA champion.
You respect the fact that we've got a job to do out here, and just get on out of here.
These guys just want to start something. Take it out of here.
Not worth it, Sid.
We've got a major main event coming up, and Mo and Mabel have just taken over the area out here,
come
and we can't
on,
get in.
Hey,
come on,
Lance Russell, like I said when I came out here earlier, the USWA belongs to King Mabel and Sir Mo, and not you, you old fossil, not you, boy, and not you, you washed up piece of trash, are going to tell us what to do anymore.
Sid, you're going to have guys forever out here doing that. Now, Sid, use your head. Don't let anybody bag you into that stuff.
You're right. Yeah, I'm not going to let those guys be the ones to do that to me.
Tracy Smothers is out here, and his opponent, Jesse James Armstrong, is, by the way, and Armstrong trying to hold Brian Christopher back.
He's coming out here.
As we are about to get underway, our main event today on USWA Championship Wrestling. This is one we've been waiting for. Wrestling out of Springfield, Tennessee at 242 pounds, Tracy Smothers. And his opponent out of Marietta, Georgia, 253 pounds, Jesse James Armstrong.
Hey, what, Corey? A
At B&B Enterprises, we figure two great minds are better than one, so Brandon and I are going to be out here today coaching Tracy to victory.
Sure, so you can have three on one. That's what you want to have.
Yeah, they figure four hands are better than two.
That's exactly what they're thinking.
That's exactly what they're thinking. I'm going to tell you something, guys. Lance, I want to thank you for stopping me. I almost lost my cool. I'm not going to allow that to happen. I'm not going to let those guys be the ones push me over that limit where I don't walk again.
And see, you're going to have guys who got nothing to lose out here trying to bait you into stuff like that, Sid. So you're just going to have to realize the situation and realize it's changed. You made your decision, a smart decision, I would add to that. So you're just going to have to be careful about it.
Lance is exactly right, Sid.
Well, guys, you know it's going to get hot out here. My second week, and I've already got my coat taken off. It don't slow down here in the USWA.
In the ring, two outstanding wrestlers. I have a very difficult time every time I watch Tracy's mother, because I used to be such a good friend of Tracy's, and I had such respect. And Tracy all of a sudden got the idea that everybody was doing him and that he wasn't getting any kind of breaks in that, and he has changed his attitude. I can't believe what's happened to him.
I'll tell you what's done that. What's caused that, Lance? It's time. Time has caused that. He feels that now he's got a turn. He's got to change a little bit. He's got to pick it up. If this is what he's got to do, I'll tell you something. I'm going to stand behind him on it.
Jesse James Armstrong on top of Smothers. Whoa. And Tracy said, hey, it's a little hot in here. Let me get out of this ring. Armstrong right on him. Boy, I thought he was going to go for a pin.
I'll tell you something, Jesse. Jesse will do what he has to do to win, too.
Oh, yeah. No, I'm not saying that's any saint up there.
Oh, hear that, boys? He's got a play.
Get him out!
B&B Enterprise, Bob and Baxter.
Boy, I'm going to tell you, they're not enough. This men on a mission is not enough today.
Sid Vicious, Corey Macklin, Lance Russell, right along ringside. Dave has got the day off today. He'll be back in town next week, though, and he is missing a dandy here. Look at that Smothers move in to the knee lift right to the midsection of Jesse James Armstrong.
Tracy Smothers and LNOA on a former tag team. Roll him up, get a pin.
Clothesline.
Boom. Body with one.
Cut box, he's got a cover. One, two.
Here we go, baby.
That's a cheap gap. And Smothers is out on the
field.
He was trying to go, Sid, it looked like, for that abdominal stretch. And Tracy was too smart. He got his way out of there before he got it on.
With a little help, if you want to say that, too. Yeah.
We need to get a noise timeout. That's what my Uncle Bobby does when the crowd's making too much noise.
Shut your mouth. I don't think that's going to stop him, Scott.
Well, the only different timeouts that his Uncle Bobby gets and the timeout he's asking for is that there's no timeout for the rest of it.
I'll remind you, Scott Bobby.
We got it under control.
Smothers back to the ring, waiting. Jesse James.
Listen, listen to those people. Listen to them.
That's it for Jesse James Armstrong, the man behind him, and Armstrong and Smothers.
Locked up and took a headlock on him.
What? And then headlock from Jesse James Armstrong. Shoulder. The top rope, and Armstrong goes flying over there.
I tell you something, I saw that coming when O'Bowd here grabbed the referee's attention.
It's what is known as teamwork.
Yeah, you're right. It is teamwork, but the wrong kind of teamwork.
First time we've ever agreed with you, Scott Bobby. Totally too much to get in there and pull that stuff on the outside. Look, Bowden choking.
Hey, if I've been out wrestling too long, is this a single or is this tag team? He said teamwork. This isn't tag team. This is singles wrestling. There he comes with that flag.
Tracy Smothers comes off the ring apron with that rebel flag. Snaps Jesse James Armstrong. Boy, this Smothers can talk a lot of trash, you know, man.
Old Brandon Baxter just walking around soaking up the glory.
Tosses Armstrong in the ring, and Armstrong sends it over.
One, two.
Armstrong able to break the count as he gets his arm on that bottom rope. That gives
gives him the break and it stops the count at two. Chasing Smothers. Breaking over the back of Jesse James on his jaw.
Digging those nails down in there, boy.
Scott Bowden over. See what happens, these type of guys can wear you down. Bowden and Baxter, every opportunity that they get, they go after you. Not time.
1 minute to go in the time limit. 1 minute to go in the time limit.
So Jesse out here looks like a
pass. He's got him, see it?
He got him, what? Come on,
oh, boy. How'd he rolled up over there? And our time is winding down in this match, our main event today on USWA Championship Wrestling.
Okay,
about 30 seconds remaining now. Smother.
Oh, here he goes.
Bring back. Oh. Whoa. Hold it.
Hold it. 30 seconds to go.
Come on, Jesse.
Smothers. And look at Armstrong go.
Our time limit running quickly down.
He's got that stretch on him, Lance.
I don't know if that was a stretch. I think he's going for like a side slam there.
Armstrong.
There he goes. Watch this. It's a side slam. Time's out.
We got to take a quick break, and we'll be right back here with you in just one moment. Well, just to put a capper on that last match, the official of it is that the time runs out. Inappropriately so for Jesse James Armstrong, because it looked like, and you never know till that last count is made, that he had Tracy Smothers with a 1-2-3, but it ends up in a time limit draw, and that doesn't make anybody happy, Tracy or Jesse James Armstrong. What a wild show today, guys.
Oh, boy, what a show today, Sid.
I'm going to tell you, it's been nonstop the whole time. Hold on, what did you say, Sid, for president? Oh, there you go. Still got a fan or two left out there.
Men on a Mission came out here. They did exactly what they said they were going to do today, Sid. They caused a lot of havoc
And I want to agree with Jerry Law on something. He came out earlier and said, let's get together, everybody band together, and let's stop these guys before they get a foothold here in the USWA. We need to stop.
Good advice, and we got to get out of here. For Sid Vicious, Corey Macklin, Dave Brown will be back next week. This is Lance Russell saying bye-bye, everybody.
The announcers on this program are selected and paid by parties other than this station, namely the promoters of USWA Championship Wrestling.